Hello everyone, welcome to NKU. I hope that you're doing well and I hope your summer has been productive so far. I know that you must be entering into the final year of your high school and you must be really excited to get started with your undergraduate degree at university next year. So I'm here to tell you a little bit more about our department. So our department is called as Department of Physics, Geology and Engineering Technology at NKU. So in today's video, I'm going to tell you a little bit more about the different programs that we have at this department and also what we do within these programs. So let's get started. Department of Physics, Geology and Engineering Technology, or what we call like PGET, is one of the 10 departments at the College of Arts and Sciences at NKU. So as you can see, we are actually housed in two different buildings. So three of our programs are actually in a Natural Science Center and two of our programs are actually in the Business Center on NKU campus. So we are kind of like very well distributed across the campus. So in this department, we actually offer five different, we have five different programs. So starting with geology, engineering technology, physics, pre-engineering, engineering physics, and we also offer like minor in astronomy. So I'm going to tell you a little bit more about each program one by one. So let's get started with geology. So I'm currently the geology program director at NKU. So in our geology program, we offer like two main degrees, so BS and BA. We also have a minor in geology, and we do offer minor in geographic information systems in collaboration with the geography program here at NKU. So far we have what, like 40 majors, 30 are doing like, you know, obviously BS in geology and 10 are doing like BA in geology. In terms of diversity, although we don't have much more diverse student population right now, but we are very excited to like recruit new students and increase our diversity. Talking a little bit more about the geology program, if you're taking like geology at the high school level, maybe you may have heard that, you know, people talk about geology in terms of rocks and fossils, but here at NKU, we actually offer courses that cover a wide range of subjects, like, you know, starting with remote sensing, so like, you know, studying like images taken by satellite, learning a little bit more about everything beyond Earth, like planets and asteroids. We study earthquakes and natural disasters, you know, things like energy and minerals like fossil fuels. And also, like, you know, if you have seen Jurassic Park, obviously you may have seen dinosaurs. So in geology, we also like study fossils as well. So that is what we call paleontology. So currently we have three full-time faculty, permanent faculty, including myself, and we have two full-time temporary faculty, and we also have like eight part-time faculty. Some of them are actually our industry collaborators. So at the bottom, you can see that these are our like area of expertise. So like I mentioned in my previous slide, we study like different topics, starting with remote sensing to, you know, paleontology, earthquakes, to all the way to virtual and augmented reality. So if you are a gamer, if you like playing games, you know, like, you know, what the virtual augmented reality is. So that also is what we study in geology program as a part of our research. So moving on, so talking a little bit more about our engineering technology program. So one of, like, a lot of the times, like, people always ask question like, okay, what is the difference between engineering and engineering technology program, right? So why I should be interested in engineering technology program, especially at NKU. So obviously I'm going to talk about the strengths of our program in the later slides, but just to like tell you a little bit more about the difference between engineering and engineering technology is that when you think about engineering, it is what we call a little bit more like a fundamental science or very basic science, where a lot of the concepts that you will study, you will need a little bit knowledge of mathematics or maybe like higher level of mathematics. So like solving like complex problem, designing like complex systems. But when you think about engineering technology, it is much more like application based. So, you know, if you're like designing systems, basically how you can actually use those system in real world applications, like so like designing the system, installing the systems, maintaining the system, and also like, you know, talking a little bit more about marketing and sales, like how you can actually like spread or like tell other people about like the systems that you're using in your job or like in the industry. So like I said, the engineering technology is a little bit more application based, whereas engineering is much more like, you know, fundamental knowledge based, or like what we call like the basic science. So at NKU, we offer engineering technology program, and this program actually has three different majors. So electrical and electronics, engineering technology, then mechanical and manufacturing engineering technology, and then we have mechatronics engineering technology. We also offer minors, especially in advanced technology, electronics technology, and industrial technology. So like, you know, for example, if you're majoring in mechanical and mechatronics engineering, maybe you would like to know a little bit more about electronics as well. So in that case, you can go with electronics technology as a minor. So as you can see up here that this is a bit approved program. So what that means is that, you know, when you go in industry, typically, obviously, industry people, they would like to hire students who actually have got quality education at the university. So ABET is actually a non-profit accreditation agency. So they make sure that whatever is being taught actually is of high quality, and the industry people recognize that education. So this is actually a really good thing that our program at NKU is ABET accredited, which means that we provide really highest quality of education in engineering technology here at NKU. So that is actually a really nice thing about our program here at PGAT. Some of the important things that you should know about our program, like EGT program here at NKU, is that, you know, based on the surveys of the graduates from this program, typically the starting salaries for EGT graduates are around like $50,000 per annum. So again, you know, as you as you get more experience through your internship or externships or even through your job, the average salaries that the graduates have received after they graduated were around like $70,000 per year. So that actually is a really good starting salary when you think about, you know, like nowadays. In the EGT program, we also offer like co-op opportunities. So when the students get into like second and third year, typically they can work with the, you know, industry to get like the hands-on experience on their like shop floor or in their offices. So it is really nice for the students to actually like, you know, apply whatever they have learned in the classes in an actual industrial setting. So the co-op program is also very active. When you think about the job placement through EGT program, it's almost 100%. You know, think about, you know, a lot of the students like who actually register for undergraduate degree or get into college, they do that because they want to have a job at the end of their, you know, degrees or when they graduate. So some of the people, most of the students, they actually have that as a main goal. So if you have 100% job placement, which means that it is almost guaranteed that you're going to get a job if you do really well, obviously, in the classes and you maintain certain GPA. But like I said, our EGT program has very qualified faculty, a really good or strong collaboration with industry, very good facilities here on campus. So I'm sure that if you, you know, get into EGT program, it is likely that you will find a job at the end, like, or once you graduate. So like I said, you know, EGT offers three different majors. So talking about mechanical and manufacturing engineering technology. So again, this major is more application based. So in this major, you will learn to like design and develop different mechanical systems or mechanical parts and processes. You will learn a little bit more about how to do like quality control of the different parts that, you know, have been manufactured. How to evaluate the standards, how to even like get involved into like technical sales. So like I said, this is much more application based. At the middle here, you can see that there is a figure of a Baja. You know, so we have a Baja club at basically PGET, where students actually develop these vehicles from the scratch, and they participate in, like, you know, national competition, and they have done, like, really well actually for many years, but at that international or national level. So, you know, if you get into this program, obviously you'll get the opportunity to participate in those competitions as well. The second major that we offer is electrical and electronics engineering technology. So again, you know, in this particular major, if you are very interested in learning more about, you know, designing circuits, studying microcontrollers, doing programming for the microcontrollers and processors, learning more about, like, electrical systems, like, you know, the transmission of the electrical system, the generation of the electrical electrical power. So this is a really good program for you. So again, you know, in this program, you'll learn a little bit more about how to apply concepts, how to install the systems, how to manufacture the systems, and also, like, commissioning of the systems. You know, so at the bottom here, you can see that we also have kind of, like, when you think about research, a lot of students actually work with the faculty in this particular major to, like, in the fields like renewable energy, or doing, like, you know, what we call, like, instrumentation. So, like, learning more about, like, automated systems. And also, like I said, like, the generation and transmission of power. So, you know, if you're interested in that, you know, this is a really good match for you. And the third program, or the major that we offer through GT program, is actually mechatronics engineering technology. So again, you know, nowadays we know that, like, robotics is, like, becoming much more popular, right? So when you go into, like, factories, people are manufacturing different systems using robots. So when you think about robots, it's like application of different fields that we discussed in the previous slides, like mechanical systems, the electrical systems, electronic system, and also, like, some knowledge of, like, the computer systems. So mechatronics is actually a really good combination of all these different areas where, you know, you can bring that knowledge together and learn more about how to design, you know, like, control systems. And also, like I said, you know, studying a little bit more about the automation side and how to remotely operate, you know, different, this robotic systems, so that while you are, like, manufacturing these electromechanical parts or processes in industry. So again, this is a really good program if you're interested in, like, those areas. So let's talk about the pre-engineering program at NKU. So if you enroll for any engineering degree across US, for the first 2 years, the courses are same, right? So if you go to, like, Stanford, if you go to, like, MIT, you know, University of Kentucky, or Penn State, or NKU, for the first 2 years, the courses are typically the same. So why NKU compared to other universities? You know, so other universities are typically much more bigger than NKU, so their class sizes are much more bigger. At NKU, our class sizes are relatively small. So what is the advantage of that? You actually get access to faculty, you know, because they're, like, small classes. Faculty, obviously, they know you by face, by your name. So you actually get much more interaction with the faculty or even with the other students compared to, like, other big universities where the classes are, obviously, like, you know, you get, like, 200 or 300 or even 500 students in one class. So you don't get that interaction at the bigger universities. At NKU, all the faculty teach, which means if you go to, like, big universities, typically they have teaching assistants or graduate students who are teaching, like, undergraduate level classes. So sometimes you don't get the knowledge that the faculty offer here at, faculty typically offer at any university. So at NKU, like I said, we typically, all the faculty teach, so you get that knowledge directly from the faculty, not from the students. Obviously, the other thing is, like, faculty are available, so we have most of our faculty, they have open door policy, so if you have any questions, you can stop by their office, you can send them an email, and nowadays, you know, you can set up a Zoom meeting, so So they'll be available for you answering the questions. That is something that doesn't happen pretty often at the bigger universities. Also the cost, right? I mean, like, one of the most important things that people, students think about coming to a university is basically cost. So NKU tuition is much more or much lesser compared to other big universities. So cost is really one of the good things about NKU. And also, like, you know, when you think about graduation, right? So when you think about bigger universities, like, a lot of students are graduating at the same time. So you get like a lot of competition for not only for the jobs, but also like facilities and resources on campus. But because NKU, like I said, is a small program, typically don't compete too much for the local jobs, but also you get to use all the resources you want because there are not many students actually trying to access the same equipment at the same time. So that is a really good thing about the pre-engineering program here at NKU. So when you think about pre-engineering program, there are two options that you can pursue. So the first option is that it's called what we call like a fast track option. So in this case, you can take classes for the first 2 years. Like I said, that are very common to across all the engineering programs, you know, the other universities. So if you take, for example, like physics one and calculus one in one semester, typically you can finish those common classes in the first 2 years. And then obviously you can switch to other university to finish rest of your program at that particular university. But in this case, you don't actually get the degree from NKU, you will get the degree from the university where you're finishing your program. But the good thing here, like I said, because you have such advantage studying at NKU, you can finish those courses in a, you know, the 2 years time, and you can move on to finish rest of your program at other university. The second option is basically what we call dual degree option. So again, if you are interested in getting 2 degrees, you know, who doesn't want 2 degrees? So in this case, you can take courses at NKU for the 3 years. So basically, you're also taking some of the upper level courses at NKU. And then once you finish that 3 year program, then you can either go to University of Kentucky or University of Louisville, and you can finish 2 more years at those universities. So if you do that, then you get another degree from the University of Kentucky or University of Louisville. So you have 1 degree from NKU, and then you have 1 degree from University of Kentucky or Louisville. So when you think about those 3 years at NKU, basically you'll be taking a lot of courses in physics. So you'll get a degree in physics from NKU, and then obviously you can get another degree from UK or Louisville. So again, this is really good because, you know, if you are nowadays, if you're going or applying for jobs, if you have dual degrees, obviously that opens up a lot of your job options. And also employers, obviously, you know, they like it, right? Because you have not only knowledge of engineering, but also knowledge of physics. So having those 2 degrees is always like an advantage when it comes to like applying for jobs. Okay, let's talk about the physics program here at NKU. So if you are very interested in like matter and energy and their fundamental interaction, physics is a really good area to get into. So students who have physics degrees, basically they become a research physicist. So they develop expertise in different areas of physics, like when you think about astrophysics or plasma physics or biophysics, you know, condensed matter physics or chemical physics. There are just so many areas where you can have your career in. So, you know, the physics program at NKU is very well established with like really good facilities on campus. So if you're trying to like have a BS degree in physics, then you need to have like 52 hours of physics education. If you want to get a BA degree in physics, then you need to have like 34 hours of physics, basically courses here at NKU. Now, one of the good things about the physics program here at NKU is like the well-respected and well-established faculty. So the researchers that you see on the screen, obviously, like I said, they are very well-respected. They do like active research here on campus. A lot of the students who get into the physics program, they get the opportunity to work with these researchers. So for example, Dr. Nutter, he works with cosmic ray experiments. Dr. Zakit, he works with computational physics. Dr. Fernando, who's also our department chair, she works with black holes and theory of general relativity. Dr. Delhi, he's also like the director of astronomy program here at NKU, and his area of expertise is more like in astronomy and astrophysics. Dr. Ramakumar and Dr. Presser, they work with like material science physics. So, you know, if you heard about carbon nanotubes, so basically that's, you know, their expertise. I have put like a small snippet at the bottom. So sometimes our physics faculty, most of the times, I guess, like I said, they're very well respected, so they get into the news. So their research is also like very well advertised. So this is a really good program if you are not only want to study the fundamentals of physics, but also if you want to get that hands-on experience working on different research projects. So the other thing about PGET is like we recently started offering a new program in engineering physics. So this program started in like fall 2019. So let's say if you are interested in engineering, but also you want to study physics, then engineering physics is a really good choice for you. So like I said, here in this program, you basically have three tracks where you can study engineering a little bit in more detail, in addition to like taking core classes in physics. So those three tracks that you have in this program is basically mechanical engineering technology, electrical and electronics engineering technology, and mechatronics engineering technology. So, so if you are enrolled into engineering physics program, then you have to complete 31 hours of physics education. And then you have to like select one of the tracks, and then you have to finish 31 hours of courses from one of those tracks. So again, like I said, if you're interested in engineering and physics, this is a really good program for you. So if you have any questions about any of this program, geology, engineering technology, physics, engineering physics, or pre-engineering, you can contact either our department chair, Dr. Fernando, or Dr. Said Alame, who is also like the director of engineering technology program. You can contact Dr. Ramakumar, he's the director of the pre-engineering program. You can contact me, I'm the director of geology program. And Dr. Delhi, his contact details are not there, but I'll make sure that I include them. He's the director of the astronomy program here at PGET. So like I said, you're always gonna have some questions. So please feel free to send us email, and we'll make sure that we'll get back to you as soon as possible. So again, if you wanna learn a little bit more about the recent news or like updates, what's going on in the department or in the program, please make sure that you go and check our website. We also have a Facebook page, where you can actually see like all the recent happenings. You can also like get in touch with people with the Facebook page as well. So I also wanted to thank you for attending this session or watching this video. And I really hope that you'll come to NKU in the fall 2021. This is a really great place. We have really good faculty here on campus. Our students are also, like I said, we have small classes, so you get like really nice bonding between the students, interaction. A lot of our programs are also like well connected to industry as well. So, especially like I said, EGT, if you're looking for jobs in engineering sector, that is a really good program to go. If you're trying to get into the research side, physics is a really good program to get enrolled into. If you like earth resources or earth systems in general, geology is also another option for you. So, again, if you have any questions, please feel free to send us an email. And I hope that your rest of the summer goes well, and good luck with your final year at high school. And we hope to hear from you sometime soon. So good luck and take care. Bye.